Hey guys, very welcome back. In this video, we'll be learning about the British occupation of Bengal. Now, if you see that in 1720s, the three Subas of the Mughal Empire, they declared independence. That was the Awadh, Bengal and Hyderabad. Now, Bengal declared independence in 1720s, by Murshid Quli Khan. 20 years later, came Ali Wardi Khan. Now, ruling for 80 years, I mean at the age of 80 when Ali Wardi Khan died, Siraj ud Daula in 1756, an angry young man, he enthroned himself and he was the grandchild of Ali Wardi Khan, grandson of Ali Wardi Khan from the daughter's side. Now, Siraj ud Daula, if you see the 1756 period, as I have already told, this was the period of the 7 year wars. The 7 year war, it started from 1756 to 1763. Okay, so at every front, French and British were competing. British were supporter of Ghaziti Begum, who wanted to dethrone the Siraj ud Daula and enthrone her second sister's son Shaukat Jung. But Siraj ud Daula managed to remain the king. Okay, so Ghaziti Begum, she conspired to dethrone Siraj ud Daula by forming an alliance with Mir Jafar Jagat Seth and Omi Chand. And the Britishers were supporting Ghaziti Begum. As I've already told that French and British were competing for greater influence, right? So what British did in Fort William, they fortified and put cannons. Now this was against the sovereignty of Siraj ud Daula. Also, Britishers, they stationed or they gave refuge to one of the said corrupt officers, Krishna Ballab, whom Siraj ud Daula called a corrupt officer. Okay, moreover, if we see, since the British, they were now openly flouting the Farman, okay, by which Siraj ud Daula was not very happy. The traders in the British East India Company, they, even when they were trading on the personal capacity, they were not paying the taxes to Siraj ud Daula. Okay, so all these factors led to Battle of Plassey, and you know, the Battle of Plassey, it was triggered when Siraj ud Daula, he went to Fort Williams and captured the British personnel and logged them, and hence it's known as Black Hole Tragedy. This made, and after this, after capturing the Fort Williams, he gave the security of Fort Williams to Manik Chand. Robert Clive, seeing all this, he bribed all the subordinates of Siraj who were unhappy with the Siraj. Okay, it included Manik Chand, it included Mir Jafar, who was the commander of Nawab's army and who was given the promise that he will be made the Nawab of Bengal, Jagat Seth, who was the banker, and Ami Chand, who was the middleman. Robert Clive bribed them and gave them hopes and aspirations of new posts. 1757, Battle of Plassey, Siraj ud Daula was defeated, Mir Jafar was crowned. In 1757-60, Mir Jafar gifted a lot to British officials, but he was fed up with British officials asking gifts regularly. and the Britishers' continued interference in the internal politics of Bengal urged Mir Jafar to side with the Dutch East India Company. In Battle of Chinsura in 1759, Mir Jafar and the Dutch East Indian Company were completely wiped off and the British emerged victorious. Seeing Mir Jafar as the traitor, he was replaced by his son-in-law, that is Mir Qasim. Mir Qasim remained the ruler from 1760 to 1763. But Mir Qasim, suffered similar problems. British asked huge money gifts from the Mir Qasim. British didn't respect the dastak system. Fed up with this, he altogether removed the dastak system and everyone was equal. Now British and Mir Qasim were on the loggerheads, right? Seeing lots of interference, he shifted the capital from Murshidabad to Munger. Also in Patna, he attacked the company's office and killed the officers, right? Again, Mir Qasim was removed and Mir Jafar, the father-in-law of Mir Qasim, was again enthroned. Mir Qasim fled to Awadh and he formed a tag team, Mir Qasim's Army of Bengal. By the way, the reason why he changed from Murshidabad to Munger to raise an independent army. Sujaud-Daula of Awadh and Shah Alam II of Mughal, they all tagged together to fight against the Britishers, and this fight on 1764 took place in Buxar, hence the Battle of Buxar. Because of superior firepower, British again won. 1763 to 1765, Mir Jafar was again the ruler. Mir Jafar gave it during this time, 1763 to 65, when he was again enthroned, Midnapur, Burdwan, Chittagong to English, duty-free trade in Bengal, right? Next, we'll see what happened after Battle of Buxar. And what is dual government of Bengal? That's all. Thank you.